According to Uganda Revenue Authority, about 50,000 cars were imported in 2017, and the numbers continue to rise. However, over 70% of the cars which are on the road are of 2003 and below models. This means that the consumer preference has to change by the end of next month. According to Uganda Revenue Authority, all cars which are 15 years and older will not be allowed to be imported into the country or cleared beyond 30th September 2018. This comes barely after URA imposed a ban on old vehicles to mitigate emissions, which have turned the environment fragile.
For example, you ordered your car on 20th June and you have a bill of lading. And it comes in 20th September. You will qualify. But if it comes in October, you are outside the period. You either have to re-export it back or re-export it to other countries that allow.
In bonds, the majority of cars are 15 years old. According to the new ban, the cars which are in bonds will also be affected.
Even when you have a car in the bond, to leave the bond and be on the Ugandan market, essentially to have transformed from the warehousing regime into the home use regime. So it would be an import into Uganda from a technical angle. Bond owners who have cars in their bonds is clear. You either clear them out if they are older than 15 years by 30th September, or if they are there by that time, we will allow you to re-export them.
The Association of Motor Dealers are contesting the ban, arguing that it should only affect the cars which will be imported into the country beyond the specified time.
My take would be, as an importer or as a trader, since they have banned the 15 cars, the cars above 15 years, give us the take to keep our cars in the bond till we sell them. If they exceed 9 months, do the needful, auction them off as normally do, or give the people a chance to re-export them.
This is a Peugeot 2004 model, which is not condemned. But under the Traffic and Road Safety Amendment Act 2018-14B, a person who imports a motor vehicle which is 9 years older or more from the date of manufacture shall pay an environment levy on the vehicle, which is 50%.
The cars that are costing about 18 million shillings, they will cost about 30 to 40 million shillings. So the cost will be high, very few people will afford.
My message to the public, to the Ugandans, is that you need to do your math properly and see where you are going to save.
This is a Primo 1999 model, one of the sought after cars in Uganda. It's preferred because of its durability and also affordability. When you get on the other side, you get to see one which is normally used as a taxi in Uganda, and it's a 2000 model. That means the owners of the bond must have cleared it by the end of September, or else they have to export it. However, I asked the customs officials as to what will happen to the cars that might be coming from other countries like Congo or even Tanzania.
For example, you are a South Sudanese, you are coming to Uganda to spend Christmas or to visit, and you are driving your car. We allow you temporary importation up to 3 months.
Last year, URA collected 446 billion shillings of revenue from car importers. I asked Kateshumbwa whether the authority will not register a slump in revenue collection, which will be detrimental.
We've seen in the region, in Kenya, we have had, I think, about three companies who are setting up assembly plants. We believe that this will attract investments in the region, in Uganda in particular.
Motor vehicles for transport of goods with a gross vehicle weight of at least 4 tons will not be affected by the ban. These include special purpose vehicles such as breakdown cars, lorries, crane lorries, firefighting vehicles, and concrete mixer lorries. Sudil Biarhanga, NTV Weekend Edition.